Do you know how to choose the right robust strategy? In today's video, I will show you two basic types of quality tests that will help you learn how to evaluate choosing the best strategy from hundreds of strategies generated by StrategyQuant. We finished the last lesson in custom project RSI Writer, where you were tasked with turning on build and letting StrategyQuant build roughly 500 to 1000 strategies according to your computer power. Now please navigate to the main results tab and make sure you are in the results data bank. I have here 417 strategies as an example, but you may have significantly more. In the case that you come up with a lot of strategies that have really good parameters, there is nothing to do but simply choose one. But this doesn't mean that when 100 strategies are generated, we test all of them and look for the best one, but we simply choose one of them and test it. In practice, it's usually best to rank the resulting strategies using the sharp ratio here in the databank in this column, and then choose a strategy among the first, say, five. For example, I choose this one. I mark the strategy and go to Tools, Edit, and Strategy, which will take the strategy into AlgoWizard. Here I can test the strategy. For start, I will change the start date from 1993 to 2005. This means that I will test the strategy on the last 20 years. Now I have to run a backtest so that I have the newest results here. This way, we are all set and we can start the robustness tests. The first test we are going to run is a parameter range test. This test can be done automatically, and if you are interested in doing it, let us know on Discord. However, now we will do it manually so you can learn something more about robustness. The key here is the entry condition that the RSI is lower than 35. The strategy had, with the parameters it generated, a profit factor of 1.75. Now I'm going to take that parameter, RSI, and reduce it by about 25%. So I set the value here at 25 and save it. I have to run a new backtest. I have to wait for the result. And I see that the profit factor has dropped, but only slightly, not substantially. That means that the downward change in that parameter has not had a major effect on the change in performance. But these parameters that genetics chose are the optimal ones, so we should rely more on the results from the testing. Now I increase the parameter by 25%, so say to 45, I save it and run the backtest again. I can see that the profit factor is basically close to the optimum. That said, changing that parameter has not fundamentally affected the strategy. I set the RSI back to the original value of 35, and let's look further. I've got a simple moving average here of 164. First of all, again, I'm going to try to reduce it by a third, or about 25%. And I try a value of 100. Again, we see that the original profit factor before was 1.75, and now it's even higher, 1.8. Now, I will add some 25% more, so I will try to change the value to 200. Save it, run the backtest, and let's wait. This process is still the same. The result is 1.59, which means, again, it hasn't changed so much, but of course the changes are somehow visible. Don't forget to reset the value of simple moving average back to the default number, which was, if I remember well, 164. Now I'm going to test the robustness of the condition in exactly the same way. I click on DEMA, which stands for double exponential moving average, and I change the time period to 90. I run the backtest again. I see that the profit factor has changed minimally, and I return the DEMA to the original 119. For the WMA, or weighted moving average, I will change the period from 77 to 100. The profit factor has changed slightly, but nothing big. So I can just reset the number back to the original 77. And save it. I'm going to test another parameter, and that's the level at which we are going to enter. We have here defaultly 0.9, and I will try 1.3. In this case, the profit factor has even increased, but the number of trades has decreased and the profit has decreased too. So let's try 0.6 instead. The profit factor dropped, but the number of trades increased significantly, and so did the profit. Now again, don't forget to return the value to its default, and it was 0.9. Then we have an exit condition where the RSI is greater than 50. When I set the value to 75 and run a backtest, we will see what happens. And the profit factor drops minimally. The thing to keep in mind is that this number must be greater than this value, or the exit would take effect immediately. So I will therefore try a value of 40. Meaning the trades will be held for a significantly shorter period of time. And even so, the strategy still holds its character. Now it's time to bring the value back to its original state, and it was number 50. With this, we have been able to verify that despite the change in parameters, the strategy is robust. However, by varying the parameters and trying different values, we got to the results that we can then predict. Another interesting test is that we try out the strategy on another index. This is called the additional market test. We retested the strategy on several markets before, because if you look back in custom projects and open the RSI writer, these were the Nasdaq 100, S&P 100, and S&P 500 markets. However, if you look in the data manager, we have other stock groups available here. Russell 1000, 2 or 3000. These are stock groups that we didn't use in this workflow because as the number of symbols grows in one stock groups, the backtest gets significantly longer. But we are not developing strategies anymore. We are testing the selected strategy, so we don't mind the backtest taking a little bit longer. In that case, I recommend downloading here, for example, Russell 1000 and do another retest on this. It means that in the first step, you need to download the data for the stock group just like you downloaded the data in the first lesson. And once you have the data for the stock group downloaded, go back to AlgoWizard. In the Data tab, change the symbol to Russell 1000 and run the backtest. You will see on the results that there really are different conditions because the strategy is developed for NASDAQ 100, which is just 100 symbols, and now we are testing it on 1000 stocks. These stocks have a very different character and contain, for example, a lot of so-called penny stocks, meaning like cheap stocks. And our strategy has to somehow deal with it. And honestly, here I would no longer require it to be completely fully profitable, but it has to have some normal course all the time. You can see in the result that the strategy loses performance towards the end, but it still has a fairly steady course. I think after readjusting a parameter like the deviation here, possibly the RSI could grow even the last years. And even if it loses performance somehow, overall, the strategy has not broken down, and that's very important. Later, when you test more of those strategies for robustness, you will find that some strategies works well even on Russell 1000, 2000 or 3000, on all of these three stock groups, which of course is a great advantage, and I would certainly prefer such a strategy over a strategy that doesn't work so well on all those indexes. Now please save your strategy for future reference. Go back to the custom project in which you created the strategy. Find it, mark it, click on Save, and select Save to SQX format. Save it anywhere on your disk. And finally, a quick summary. In this video, you saw two simple robustness tests. We tested the parameters, always changing them continuously plus or minus 25%, and looking to make sure that the character of the equity curve didn't drop significantly or that the performance didn't drop more substantially. And then we tested the strategy in another market, the Russell 1000 stock group, and there we found that the strategy still had a normal path. Stock picking has a great advantage in terms of robustness itself, given that the strategy has to work on hundreds or thousands of symbols at the same time. It is not easy to find a strategy that is overfitted, and that in itself is a sign of robustness. Robustness can be tested much more deeply. If you are interested, however, robustness is a widely discussed topic on our Discord. So don't forget to like and follow so you don't miss out on news from the world of algo trading, and see you in the next lesson.